I've been speaking about speciality in many places, in many conferences. And people have difficulty trying to define speciality. Now, this is my definition, okay, which is very similar to Frankl's. So my definition is that speciality, which resides in all of us, express itself in serving something bigger than ourselves, and serving something bigger does not make us spiritual. It all depends on the motive and the value behind one's service. And that will become clear later on. So basically what I'm saying is that we all have this divine spark in us. Whether you're religious, not religious, believers or atheists, it doesn't matter what you believe. It doesn't matter what you believe. The fact that we are created in the image of God means that deep in our soul there is a divine spark. And it lies latent, waiting to be awakened. Does that make sense to you? There's a cry for meaning, cry for speciality. There's a silent cry in our soul that waiting for answers, waiting to be awakened. Now, stay with that for a while, okay? But, although the need is to do something that transcends our interest, but doing something bigger than ourselves does not make us spiritual. It could come from the devil, it can come from ambition or greed. For example, Hitler killed many people doing something big. And the two brothers do something that got attention from the whole wide world. They are doing something bigger than themselves, but it's not looked upon as something, an act of speciality, rather an act of terror, a terrorist, right? So doing something big by itself doesn't qualify, it's not an expression of speciality. But it also have to depend on the motive and the value. You're motivated by the desire to serve for the betterment of the greater good. You're motivated by the desire to serve God, to glorify Him. So your motive is positive, the effect is positive, then you are on a spiritual path. So this is an important point from Frankl, okay? Now here's something, okay? The entire meaning enterprise is based on the foundational belief that we are spiritual beings in need of meaning, and human life has intrinsic meaning and value. Now let me explain to you what I mean. The whole enterprise of logotherapy or the quest for meaning, it rests on the fundamental belief. You can call it faith, you can call it belief. The human capacity to believe in something invisible, something intangible, something mysterious, something beyond our comprehension. And that is the capacity to believe is unique to human. Okay? Mm-hmm. You don't see the animals worshiping God or believing in something that cannot be seen, cannot be felt. The capacity to believe is the key to spiritual life. It's a key to spiritual care. It's a key to unlock the mysteries of the universe, the mysteries of the transcendental reality.